So it's sort of cool that top k via partitioning, as just described, works. It gets us the top k values in not sorted order. All right, let's do an analysis of the time it takes for top k to do its work via this partitioning approach. And because it's a recursive algorithm, it's going to help to set this up in terms of recurrence relations. So here's the recurrence relation we want to solve. The time it takes to run top k via partitioning on one element, we'll call that 1. And the time that it takes to run on n elements is going to be hard to write down exactly, but we can put down a bound. So what does it do? First, it does the partitioning operation, which runs through all the elements of the list. That takes time n. Then what's going to recurse, assuming it hasn't gotten really lucky, and since this is a less than or equal to, let's assume it didn't get lucky, it's going to recurse on either the left or the right. Now, the partitioning algorithm is going to split this list, L, into a left and a right. In the different cases, it's going to recurse on either the left or the right, but we don't know which one it's going to recurse on, and we don't know which one is bigger. So what do we know? Well, it's just as likely for the left to be bigger as it is for the right to be bigger, and vice versa. So really, you can imagine with justification that with probability a half, the left side is bigger, and in particular, bigger than size n over 2. And in half the cases, right is bigger, and again, bigger meaning that it's going to be at least size n over 2. So if the recursive algorithm gets called on the smaller half, then the work that it has to do is whatever the recursive running time is on a list of size n over 2 or smaller, this is an upper bound, and that happens with probability a half. But we might also get unlucky and have to recurse on the larger half, which could involve actually something almost the size of the entire list. So that's kind of a weird recurrence relation because it has probabilities in it. But really, we want a bound on the running time. How many steps is it going to take, in this case on average, for top k to finish its job? And this gives us an upper bound. This recurrence relation gives us an upper bound. All right, so to solve this recurrence relation, I'm going to cheat a little bit because I know that 4n is going to be a good upper bound on the value of t of n. So all we have to do is actually prove that that's true. We don't actually have to figure it out. So to prove that this is true, we're going to proceed by induction. So our base case is t of 1 equals 1, which is indeed less than or equal to 4. For our inductive step, we know from the structure of the algorithm that the time it takes to handle an input of size n is on average going to be less than or equal to n plus a half t of n over 2 plus a half t over n, just like we argued before. And now we're going to use our inductive hypothesis that t of n is less than or equal to 4n to get an upper bound on this quantity. So t of n over 2, we're assuming, is upper bounded by 4n over 2, which is 2n. And this quantity, t of n, we're assuming is less than 4n. Now this is a little bit of an abuse of or mathematical abuse of induction. We really don't want this to be n here because our inductive step is going to assume that's true for everything smaller than n, not equal to n. But the reality is this is actually a tiny little bit less than n. The worst possible case that you get in this algorithm is we picked a partition on the end and then we recurse on everything but the end. So it's a t of n minus 1 here. But it's, yeah, with apologies, you can make these details all work out, but it's a little irritating. So with that caveat, we proceed. What we have is this is equal to n plus 2n, which is indeed 4n. So we've now shown that for each value of n, t of n is always upper bounded by 4n. And that's what we wanted to show. But this is pretty remarkable, because what that means is we actually find the top k elements in big theta of n. You know, 4n is big theta of n. So the running time is going to be linear, which is pretty neat.